shit, dog, word up. We'd be all up in Washington. Weed's legal. Redman's like, yeah, man. And you can mix it with tobacco. Shit. Not us, right? So, I was gonna start it with the camera in the lab stand so I can just do the fucking dab. But then I noticed it was aiming down and it was all awkward and weird. So, for this video, if you didn't read from the title, I'm gonna do the static tech, cleaning tech, whatever the fuck, with to clean up some B-grade dry sift and make it into some full melt dry sift. So first I'm gonna dab, if you've already seen the other dry sifting video, which was the 10 second sift tech, and that was pretty much the two screen dry sift lizard tech. And that's, matter of fact, that's where I got the screens. This is the third screen. There's a two screen kit and a three screen kit. Now the two screens are good to make this, but the third screen is the 70 micron or 200 lines per inch. And that's what's done, used for cleaning, whether you're carding it the old school way or doing the static tech. Is where I got the static tech from. I got it actually pretty much where everyone else got it from. The Bubble Man video. And if you're watching this, it might just be because you like to watch my videos, or maybe you didn't see the Bubble Man dry sift quiver video. And pretty much, if you watch the old D420K dry sifting video where he mentions the not the iTunes cards themselves, but the actual card that the iTunes card is stuck to, how it's static on one side or some shit, like, pretty much what he is saying is the contaminant sticks, either doesn't stick to one side or does or whatever, but either way, I don't know about the, I'm not going to say the contaminant sticks to anything, but I am going to say the heads would stick to the other side, and if you did that like 50 times, you'd yield a dab. Well, now, doing it with a DVD case, like I'll show you in a few minutes, and you use parchment paper to wrap it up like a Christmas present, it's a lot thicker than a, you know, like a card that you would card with. So there's a lot thicker edge on it to collect those heads. And that's kind of what I'm going to show you in this video. And like I said, if you've already watched the Bubble Man's video, then you already know exactly what I'm going to do. If you follow me on Instagram, most of you probably already know what I'm about to do. But I'm going to go ahead and do it on here because this is something I haven't done on YouTube yet. And people keep asking me if I have. And I'm having a hard time getting a dab because that thing should have my rig under it, which is calling it my rig. This one's Archie's. Okay, so this is kind of a lame shot. Let me, now I'm in the light, so let me just turn your guys' light on. And I almost touched the nail to focus, because you know you got to touch your phone screen where you want it to focus. Almost touched the nail. Like with my finger instead of on the screen. So that was weird. Oh, I guess I can raise it. I can do this. Using by all my little tripods, like this one, a leg broke on it, and then I got another one that broke. And then I have the one that's at work that's not broke, but I'm gonna leave that there for the work sessions and any kind of selfie that I may need to take and can't hold my phone. But as far as, get this hot so it sticks. As far as tripods here, I just got the real tripod, the big one, and then I got this lab stand. So, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take this dab and then get to it, get the party started, get to cleaning some sift because I got quite a bit to clean. So, quite a bit by my standards. I'm sure some of you guys are gonna look at that and laugh and go, that ain't even 2 ounces. But, alrighty, cheers. Guys, we're smoking fucking keef. Pretty much, and I'm gonna explain this just like I did on Instagram. HH mix, like I've said a lot of times, is a mix of strains from the gardens that Tony does, which the same strains are also in gardens that Archie does, but when Tony does them, he'll do like one plant of that strain, so it's rare that I have a pound of one kind, or even 8 ounces of one kind, which is a half pound, to do a strain-specific run with it. So I pretty much mix them all together, like Maui Wowie and Lemon Skunk and all the shit that I get from this grower. Well, I had 8 ounces of Blue Diesel, so I went ahead and did that separate, but I took all the B grade from it. And if you don't know what I'm talking about when I'm saying B grade, you got to watch my original dry sift video, and you'll see the good shit that we smoked went through both the screens. That middle screen, a lot of stuff landed on it. What I do with that is it lands on there, but I pick the screens up so I can scrape this good shit up, which is good already, doesn't need any cleaning. And then I put the screens back down on the glass where this stuff was, but I already scraped it up. And then I go ahead and card the shit back and forth on that middle screen until it all falls through except for pistols and big pieces of plant matter and shit that made it through the 220, but they landed on the 170. So, and I'm talking micron there, not lines per inch. So pretty much everything that is in this B grade that I'm about to clean is what landed on that 170 and then got carted through it. So it's all smaller than 170 micron and larger than fucking zero. So I don't know if I can get a good shot of this. Yeah, there we go. Damn, it looks like I'm shaking all crazy. Let's see if I can support my hands. Oh well, you guys get the point. And this, honestly, they both look the same. I hate unscrewing fucking jars with one hand. Forget it, they both look the same. You can see, look at it through the glass. There we go, so I don't have to unscrew this shit. So since the Blue Diesel is a strain that's always in the HH mix anyways, I went ahead and took all the B grade from the Blue Diesel and mixed it with the B grade from the HH mix, which was, I believe, Phantom Cookies, Platinum Cookies, and two other strains I forgot. But I mentioned them on my Instagram. What you doing, buddy? Huh? You wanna make some dry sift? You wanna make some dry sift? Tell everybody that you're not mad at me for waking you up yesterday. People think I was a dick for that. Yet they seem to ignore when you fucking chew the shit out of me and bite me and jump up on me and fucking tear me up and give me scars. Oh, that don't exist, but I'm a dick for waking your ass up from your fucking sleep that you can't get any other time because, you know, you're so busy working and whatnot. He did get me back last night. I don't know if it was L's that showed up or what, but he decided to bark like a motherfucker and wake me up. So here is the screen. The Gorilla Tape sticks to the parchment paper better than Scotch Tape. So that's the tape that I used. You just got to wrap it tight. And also, when you wrap the corners, fold them kind of like a Christmas present. But make them not, don't have like a big edge on here. So you have to kind of pull it tight. Because if you do, when you're scraping across your keef, you'll leave two little streaks right here. And this will always just collect a bunch of, it'll press heads and just stick all kinds of shit to the corners, which you have to just flick off into your trash pile that you can't even clean because now it's pressed. Once, anytime the sift like greases or sticks together to where the actual gland heads break and or melt, you can't really do this to clean it up. And I'm sure 5,000 motherfuckers, I guess since hair straighteners are, you know, cool for pressing your hash, now that brought back rosin from the fucking dead. So now this whole new generation of stoners that just started making hash in the last year or two, never heard of it, And every day I get like 10 fucking comments like, hey, check out this rosin shit. Check out this rosin shit. Now understand, if you do it, fucking cool. Awesome. I tried it before. Now I have the equipment to make this stuff. So I could see if you didn't have the equipment to make any decent dry sift, you didn't have any bubble bags, you either didn't like BHO or you're making a smart decision and not making it in a dangerous way, then I completely support. Go for it. Make the rosin, smoke the rosin, smoke the hell out of it. But fuck, I don't know. I guess people just like to be the first to tell me some shit. But in case you know now, you're 300th to tell me if you go ahead and tell me. So yes, for everybody that's gonna leave a comment, I've heard of it. The sift's over here. So this is about 35 grams. And I got about 4 grams of, I could have maximized that, and I'll talk about that too. But I got about 4 grams of like full melt, and I got like 35 grams of this B grade. And the main reason was I was like doing like 4 or 5 ounces at a time of material when I was doing what I did in my other dry sift video. I think it's making dry sift and dabbing it with Archie. I think that's the title. But I was doing what I did there, except I was doing it with a lot more sift. I mean, sorry, with a lot more material. And what happens is it makes your second screen completely get covered with contaminant, which once that happens, your heads can't fall through anymore. They just land on the contaminant. So that's got a lot more heads in it than my usual B grade. In my usual B grade, I can pull about 40 to 50% of it is full melt. And if that's the case for this, I will be very happy, because that'll mean that I'll have 17 fucking grams of full melt, which splits in half. People think, oh, you made some of that, so you're gonna smoke it all. No, instantly, I split it in half, and Archie takes his half, I take my half, and then I smoke my half quicker than he smokes his half. So after I'm done with mine, then I have to be a mooch until we do another run, which is now. So I get to end being a mooch today. Another thing, oh dude, this feels so heavy. It's crazy. And it's of decent quality. I'll do it over here in case it falls. It's the sideways mountain. It's not going nowhere. But at the same time, I've been using playing cards lately because I go through so many of them. Could still do that. So I'll start with like that much, which is around 3 or 4 grams. And the very, very first thing I'll do, since it isn't greased by any means, but the heads are sticking together because it is sticky fucking resin. And the temperature in here, I don't have my IR gun, I don't think. But yes, I do. I have it. Let me go grab it. -62 degrees. That's what we're rocking at. So really nice temperature to fuck with this. You want low humidity too, but I live in Washington and it's raining outside right now, so can't really do much, especially when your dehy is fucking as old as you. So now I'm gonna do what I was talking about, where it's just kind of breaking it up. If it breaks up easy, cool. And I don't have to necessarily do it like it's cocaine. I could, you know, just kind of squish it out like that. But on, it's not a good thing I would recommend. Because if it's really sticky shit, you could just be pressing it when you do that. Oh, another thing I should mention as I'm looking at this really clean screen. I don't use the shop vac. I actually use the vacuum, the regular vacuum that I vacuum the floor with, but I don't pick it up and put it on the screen. I use the hose, and then with the hose, there's that adapter that has the scrubber. That works great because it like flicks off all the little pieces of stuff that's stuck to the screen. And I like to do that between runs, even when I'm using the the two screens that are over there for doing the tech. And the bigger, the more surface area you have, the better, for the reason like I talked about before, where the second screen gets covered up with contaminant and your heads can no longer get through. If I just had them all like this size, oh, I'd be fucked. I'd be having to do like 2 ounces at a time or less just to not have so much be in my B grade. But I'm kind of thinking that what I might be doing is getting a tumbler with, I think it's got like a 150 on it or something like that, the screen that's on the tumbler. I don't know if I'll get a tumble now or not because I don't need to actually pay extra to have it made out of wood and have that 70 micron screen on there. Though if I didn't have this and wasn't doing what I'm about to do and show you guys with the static, and let's say I was just tumbling and carting, that would be perfect. That's what I would get. But since all, and we might even get one of them great big ones that that Great Gardener has. I forgot it's a Canadian company that makes those. But pretty much what I'm saying is I want to just fucking throw the material in a thing, let it make what I just showed you that's in that bowl, let it make some of that, and then I'll do this to it. And I think that'll be cool too. But yeah, I don't know. I don't, to the other thing, like I worked, it pretty much yield about 1 gram an hour, which is, I don't know. I wish I could just buy this shit. And the only people that like vend it to shops, I mean, it's gone the very same day that it goes out, and it's $80 or $100 a gram. So yeah, it's pricey, and I'd have to travel all the way to Seattle to get 1 gram a week. So I do still kind of have to make it to smoke it. And yeah, I'm smoking this, so is Archie, and he don't care that I'm not wearing gloves. So all the people that worry more about what I'm putting in my body than worrying about their own self, who are worrying about me, gonna go ahead and make something without some gloves. Just go ahead and feel however you want to feel. Sorry. So I'll use about this much, and I'll spread it out like this. Just kind of getting a little spread, and I think I'm going to lower this down because I really want you to see what the fuck's going on when this happens. And someone on Instagram, I forgot who it was, he uses a paint roller wrapped in parchment, and it does the exact same thing. I don't know if his results, I mean, is are he might be yield. I don't know. I still have to try it. It just keeps passing my mind when I'm out and about, but I need to stop at Lowe's and get me a clean paint roller. And he isn't actually rolling it, he's dragging it. So just keep that in mind. Rolling it isn't going to do anything for you because the contaminant would just get mixed right back in it. And another thing I'm going to say, the better the stuff you're starting with, the more you're going to get. Okay? If you're starting with some just fucking dry ice Keef, I wouldn't even try it with that. But if that's all you got, don't expect more than like 10% or whatever. And that's 10% from your keef, not from the weed. So like right here, I've got 35 grams of keef. I'm aiming for like 40 or 50% off of that. But that came off 20 ounces, so a pound and a quarter. So keep that in mind. And also, I could have sifted the material longer and gotten more. I think people they don't keep that in mind, or they don't recognize that when I talk about the yields that I get. If I was just doing that with material and that was the end of it, I was had to get as much out of it as I did, I would be using the fucking tumbler like I was just talking about and doing different, 1 minute, 10 minute, hour, whatever the fuck, and having my different grades that I would then clean up, and I'd get a lot more out of it than what I do. But yeah, the most I've done is about a little over 4% count, 4% full melt from the plant material, which is fucking, that's almost enough to make it worth doing commercial until you hear that it took 12 hours to make 17 grams, which was not very commercial. So, alrighty, here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and drag it one swoop. And notice it didn't go very far. I'm gonna go ahead and do it again. There you go. So as you can see on this edge is just heads. And then on the side, there's little bits of contaminant, not much. As you get down, there'll be more contaminant stuck to it. And I have pictures on Instagram. Archie even has one on his Instagram where I've got all the contaminant on this side and then heads on this side. I guess I could use this. Which I'm sure isn't clean, but you need to have something set aside to, and a clean card, not the card that you use to touch anything. You have two, I shouldn't say you, because this is just the way I do it, and I'm nowhere near having this down. I'm just doing like all the other people on YouTube, making a how-to video on something that I don't completely understand myself, but I'm admitting it, rather than other people that act like experts showing you something that they just learned. But yeah, people have been asking me to make it, and that's why I'm fucking making it. Keep in mind, there's way more experienced people that you can get the info on this from. Don't think that that you're getting the best information here, because you're definitely not. I've been making dry sift for what? 4 months now? This is probably under 20 batches. Okay, so here we go with the goodies. So as you saw, I just scraped that off with this card. Now we go grab another card. The Five of Hearts, which is going to be our goodie. And it does go a little bit faster when you're not talking and trying to just show little bits at a time. But I'll go ahead and show you what we got there, which is almost a dab's worth. Ooh, you guys see that contaminant? I think I fucked up. Damn. I think we'll have to smoke that. Either way, it's better than what we started with. Damn, that looks pretty good. Damn, that looks fire. If only you knew. So, damn, it looks like a lot of contaminant when I had it on the, looking through the thing all zoomed in, but I got down there with my eyes and I can't even see it. It's crazy. We'll roll with that though. So, zoom back out. Take my, oh, damn it. And that really sucks when that happens, because now you have to go get a paper towel and wipe this whole motherfucker off because it fell on the floor and it probably has a hair on it. From your ass, bread man. Alrighty. So here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and do it again. Each time, I don't do this every fucking swipe, but when you do this, I definitely, after it's all spread out, I will scrape it up again and go over it one or two more times before I'll scrape it over into a pile. Actually, I'll just show you. I'll just keep on going. We're fucking 25 minutes in now. I'll just keep going and I'll show you what happens when I get to the point that I've sifted all this and add more. So I'm gonna start talking a little less. If you don't care to just watch this repetitive shit, you can go ahead and skip forward till you see something interesting on your little skipper screen. I don't know, but here we go. See the contaminant stuck to it, and that's also the press stuff, like I was talking about, that you can no longer clean. So that stuff, damn, there's actually some good shit with it. I don't care. Fuck it. And you gently scrape that off because you have your heads that you don't want to lose. And if you don't scrape this off first, you'll do what I just did over there. And then see, I still left some on here because I'm scared that these heads are going to knock off. So I'll do what I did on my last run when I was experiencing this. And I'll scrape it off right over here. So in case I do a contaminated one, I don't throw it right in my main pile. But I started doing that when I had had a decent pile. It wasn't my first scrape just sitting there. Now I can scrape this shit over here. So another thing you want to do through this, another tip is keep this edge clean because any bump on it, like there just was, is gonna make it to where it's not flicking the shit up right. And I guess I'll explain what's actually fucking happening because I'm sure there's a lot of people that are just seeing it and going, I don't get what's actually really going on. What's going on is, put this over here. What's going on is you're going over the heads and everything. You got heads and you got other shit there too. And what's happening is the plant material isn't hard and brittle or hard, just it's soft, squishy, fucking spongy material. So when you're sliding, it actually just squishes down. It doesn't flick up pretty much. That's in order for it to be what I've got over here, what it has to do is flick up and stick to the side of this. When you're doing it with a regular card, since it doesn't have a thick ass edge, since it's thin, it flicks up and sticks to the back side of the card. But with this, it flicks up and sticks to the edge. Plant material either sticks down here or just stays on your screen or falls through your screen. But the goodies flick up and stick. And that's all that's happening there. To do an experiment, people thought this looked like an ice cream sandwich in my picture that I posted, and I was out of Gorilla Tape, so I used Scotch Tape. But I used this case, which is it's what a pin came in. It was like a pin kit, so it's thicker, and I figured because it had a bigger edge, it would catch some shit that I was missing, which it's kind of cool to do that experiment because I got to see how far up the shit would go, and it didn't really go up further than the thickness of a DVD case anyway, so that's why I'm still using the DVD case. Oh, something I should have said a long time ago. If you know any tips, and I'm talking about you do these tips, not your friend, not someone you heard say, do this, because I sure get a lot of that. People leaving comments saying to do something that they didn't even do, they just heard, and they don't really understand it. So, if you make sift and you know any tips as far as this goes, go ahead and leave that on there. If you do it the regular old school cardy way, then when I make a video about that, if I ever go back to doing that tedious shit, then you can probably tell us about your carding in that video. But yeah, if you do this static, let me know. What do you use? Do you got any crazy tools or something? We're gonna go ahead and just use what we got here because if I just do it with little bits like that at a time, this is gonna take me hours. So we'll step up our amount here. And before runs, I'll do this. My hands end up getting real sticky fucking midway through the run. I just had to take the parchment off. Dude, the Scotch tape that I had parts, I was taping this last part, here it is, I can show you. This ain't even the tape side, this is the opposite side of the adhesive side. That's my fucking stuff from my fingers, hash from my fingers. From the last run, from holding the ship and scraping. So, Here we go.
Cheer. Almost.
No, I feel like I was taking a hit. See that line? See that line it just made from the corner? That's what I was talking about when I was saying that. See the contaminant on that side and the goodies on that side? What I do to get the contaminant off, because I never want to scrape when there's that much contaminant there, is I'll just go finish my scrape not in the sift. If you finish your scrape and pick it up in the sift, that's why that's there. If you finish your scrape on clean screen, then that's all you're dealing with. So now, as you notice, since I was using more, the only part that like pressed is up here in the corner, and you got to be really careful getting those off, because when you, it can be a flick, and those are trash, by the way, but it can be just enough tap to knock your goodies off. The garbage man is here, picking up our garbage. So, I wanted to press that and take a dab, but I'm just gonna go ahead and keep on going. And then, or I guess I can explain what I do from here, and then just take a dab, because really, me to just continue what I was doing is kind of pointless, but I just keep doing this. And then after I've done this enough with this stuff, I'll scrape it over here with this. And then after I've repeated that process like two or three more times to where I have a decent amount right here, I'll scrape that back out and start doing it to all with that. And I end up getting to the point to where I have a pile that's about the same size right here is my pile of goodies. And then keep in mind, I have about half as much as what's right here, and this is very dependent on the size of the heads, but or in the shit that you have, because there's contaminant, depends on that size too. But sometimes I'll have 50-50, same amount on top of the screen as I do that fell through the screen. And under the screen, I'm sure there's people that's been wondering this whole time, am I just letting it fall onto my pool table? No, I got a piece of cardboard under there for those who are wondering, but it's too late now. We're 33 minutes into the video, and I know none of you waited, so you probably already left a comment. So, there we go. You see what I'm saying? Versus sitting there carding forever. Whoever came up with that, and a lot of people say D420K, and I don't know if it was really him who, or if he's the one who did it, or if he's the one who did it with the card, and that inspired somebody to do it this way, or if people had seen him do it with the card, and they assume that's what I'm talking about when I say static tech. I don't know, but I'm sure since now we're on YouTube versus Instagram, I'm sure though there might be some people that know more about it because it did come from YouTube as far as where I figured it out. So where was it? Where did Bubble Man get it? Or does he say? Because he does say with the two screen tech, he does admit that it's dry sift wizard even though he hates his guts. So that I expect that if it is somebody else, he says who it is. And I didn't hear him say that it was him. who did it. I don't know. All I know is whoever did, fucking props, man. Whether you saw D420K do the same with the card did and you were repeating that and going, damn, I just need a thicker edge. Or maybe you did it from the beginning. Or maybe D420K, you did it. I say it like he's fucking watching the video or something. But anyways, whoever did it, fucking props. Thank you. This is awesome. And now I'm able to actually make more than a few grams of this at a time. Oh, also, whenever you scrape it up, it cleans the screen, because when you have a whole bunch of shit in the screen, you don't get as good of a flick as you do when you're scraping it over clean screen. Something else I've noticed. I completely forgot the video camera's still rolling. I was just doing me, man. I don't know how much tape we got left. I mean, sorry, battery. That might be about to die. For those of you who wonder why I say tape instead of memory or whatever, it must be nice being that young to not remember fucking having to rewind shit. But yeah, we actually had to do that. And then when we wanted to watch something else, some of you might even remember having to take a DVD out and put a new DVD in, rather than just clicking another fucking thing to watch. We actually had to take the fucking thing out, put another, or if we're smart, we rewind it before we took it out. And then we grabbed the other one, which some idiot put up, so we'd have to rewind that too. Rewinding. And then you have like these VCRs, like when Grandpa had this one that rewound hella fast, but it didn't slow down after it got to almost to the end of the tape. Like some of the smarter ones, you know, like the 80s ones when they started to get really good, you'll hear them rewinding like a RCA or some shit. And it starts to get almost to, in my look, my camera does this, my mini DV camera does this. It'll rewind really fast and be like, and then it gets almost to the end of the tape and it slows down. My grandpa's didn't. It gets to the end of the tape and snapped that shit. So that sucked. All right. Ooh, yeah, and there it warned me about my battery. 14% left. Let's see if we can get zoomed in with this shitty digital zoom that these fucking digital cameras have and these fucking phones. Speaking of the olden days. Fucking. Whoa, why is it blinking? Are you guys seeing that too, or is that just me? Oh, there we go. Oh, it's doing it too. I guess it's whenever I focus on the parchment. Whatever. Fuck, I forgot. Oh yeah, optical zoom. Whole lot better than this fucking digital zoom. No pixels and shit like that. Fuck, my T3i has optical zoom. I mean, so that shit ain't extinct. I don't think it'll ever be. Because there's always going to be people who care about quality. Your fingernails are dirty. You guys remember them old Dave Warden videos? Yes, that deck has a slab on the bottom. Oh yeah, and then this fucking bubble hash fucking washer. Oh yeah. Man, I love this thing. I use it so much. Just kidding. I rock a pyramid bag with it. Oh, there's my 90. My 90 and my 73, them two good ones. I think that's a 120 right there, too. And then a 45. And then a fucking 190. Which I thought was weird when I first got that. And then I'm like, oh, I see. So now I'm gonna take a dab of the shit that we just cleaned up, in case you didn't figure that out already. So, focus, bitch. And I can't use my light because we're under 14% battery. So, sorry about that. I was just going to say, go back and look at the melt of the other one to compare, but I think that light might fuck with you. Fuck. It's so shattery of shit that it makes. Of the dry sift is so shattery that my dabber doesn't want to stick. I think I'm... Fuck. It's going to make it take longer, but I got to show you what I mean when I say shattery. This is what I mean. Oops. Now we wasted some. That's what I mean when I say shattery. Dry resin, not squish, stick, sizzle. There we go. What's awesome about this compared to rosin and pretty much everything that I dab compared to rosin, I've got all them volatile terps that you smell fucking evaporating away. I don't know why. I mean, that's the when someone was commenting saying he thinks it tastes bad. I'm used to dabbing shit that's not fucking decarbed. So when I dab some shit that tastes like the fucking reclaim in my vaporizer wand, I mean, that's where I would get it. But if I was, if that, you know, if I didn't really care about the flavor and all that, I'd be dabbing this fucking 96 point whatever percent THC clear shit. But that's me. That's because I have access. And like I said, you don't have access to any of that shit. That's what rosin's for. And there is a lot of people, I bet a lot of you watching this don't have access to, you know, the kind of, you know, to go buy. I mean, I don't even have access to this because I have to fucking make it. That's how I get my access to it. But a lot of you, you know, to get your concentrates, the most practical way would be for you to take a bud or some, do it the old school way with some grinder keef like I did, or fucking Moroccan hash, or whatever like the Dutch people who invented it did. But if you get do a, like juicing your bud with the hair straightener, that's fucking quick, easy, efficient. Some people are getting like 10% yields. So, I mean, there's a lot of pros to that. So yeah, I definitely, I'm not hating on people who do that. Just hating on people who keep fucking asking me about it over and over and over and haven't took the time to read a comment or a post where I've already addressed it. So here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and dab this shit. Probably said 10,000 words in the last 45 minutes. That might be a conservative estimate. But here we go. Cheers. Now, before I end it, I'm gonna show the 10, what's called is the 10-second sift, and a lot of people take that shit too literal too. They think it means you sift for 10 seconds. That's it. That's the tech. And the reason there's a time even mentioned is because to make full melt dry sift, the cleaning takes a lot of long time. The 10-second sift tech, which is the two-screen tech, the like I talked about in my other video shows. If you know what 10-second sift is, watch my other dry sift video I talked about in this several times. But it's pretty, I mean, it's because in 10 seconds, you can make it. Now, I'm making more than one dab, so obviously it's going to take me longer than 10 seconds. But I can make a dab in 10 fucking seconds, zero cleaning. That's why it's called 10-second sift. It's not, you have to do something for 10 seconds or it's not 10-second sift. That's like people thinking you have to use naphtha or it's not RSO. Why am I in the tripod? Oh, why am I picking it up like that instead of just taking it out of the thing? So here's the shit we just made, doing that static. And here's the shit that came from the 10-second sift. Let me see if I can get these fuckers right next to each other. So they're both in the same. Sweet. I have already fucking got as much of that, minus a dab, as I do of that in less than an hour, fucking 40 minutes, which half of that was wasted from talking, so really 20 minutes. So whatever, I'm just going to go back to what I'm doing. I have this whole fucking bowl of it to clean up, so I will do that. Oh, let's do a little before and after, how about that? The one arm life, doing everything with one arm. Before, after, before, after. See? That shit right here, this looked real good at the beginning of the video, didn't it? Until you're seeing it next to that. Well, a whole bunch of that is mixed up in here. And I want to take that color stuff out of that. You get what I'm saying? So, that's my video. Again, like I said before, this isn't anything I fucking came up with or invented. I don't like that, I mean, there's fucking, some dude just tagged me in some dude's rosin, some dude had this rosin fucking video, and some dude said, Brett can make oil with a screen in 10 seconds or some shit. Or Brett has this tech where he makes oil with a screen in 10 seconds or some shit like that. I'm like, oh God, no. I do this tech that someone else came up with that makes dry sift in that, you know, 10 seconds. But, oh well. But I'm running out of words, so we'll go ahead and end it with that. This is already going to be a big-ass fucking 7 gigabyte video, so it's going to take forever to upload. All right, peace.